Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss transcription in prokaryotes along with the various multiple choice questions asked from this particular topic in various entrance examinations. So first, definition of transcription. So transcription is defined as a synthesis of RNA molecule using the DNA as a template that results in the transfer of the genetic information stored in the double-stranded DNA into the single-stranded RNA, and which is used by the cell to direct the synthesis of proteins, which is a translation. And gene is defined as a functional unit of DNA that can be transcribed. Now, this transcription is always selective in comparison to that of replication, which is non-selective. So, transcription is selective, that means the entire molecule of DNA is not expressed in transcription. RNAs are synthesized only for some selected regions of DNA. For certain other regions of DNA, there may not be any transcription at all, and the product which is synthesized at the end of the transcription is called as a primary transcript. Primary transcript is present in the inactive form, and they undergo certain alterations which are commonly known as a post-transcriptional modifications, which involve splicing, terminal additions and base modifications to produce functionally active RNA molecules. Now, cellular RNA contain four types of RNA. First one is the messenger RNA, second one is the ribosomal RNA, third one is the transfer RNA, and the fourth one is the small nuclear RNA. Now, the messenger RNA, ribosomal RNA and transfer RNA, they are involved in the translation or protein synthesis process, and the small nuclear RNA is involved in the mRNA splicing. So, this is the picture showing the different types of RNA present in the eukaryotic cell. First one is the messenger RNA, which transfer the genetic information for the synthesis of protein. Second one is the transfer RNA, which has clover leaf-like structure, and it is the smallest among all the RNAs, which is involved in the transport of amino acid for the translation process. Third one is the ribosomal RNA. Ribosomal RNA is the RNA present in the ribosomes, and again it is important for the translation process. And the fourth one is the microRNA. So this is the picture showing the different types of eukaryotic RNA. Now, basic requirements for the transcription process. So, there are three basic requirements for the transcription process. First one is the template, second one is the substrates, and the third one is the enzymes. So, first we will see the template. So, single strand of DNA act as a template. And the DNA strand, which is transcribed to RNA molecule, is referred as a template strand, which is also called as a sense strand or known coding strand. And the other DNA strand is referred to as a coding strand of the gene, and it is also called as a nonsense strand. So this is the picture showing the coding strand, template strand and mRNA transcript. Nucleotide sequences, which is present in the mRNA transcript, is always complementary to that of template strand, and it is identical to that of coding strand. So this is the picture showing the coding strand, template strand and mRNA transcript. Now, substrate required for the transcription process. So first one is the ATP, second one is the GTP, third one is the CTP, and the fourth one is UTP. So these are the substrate required for the transcription process in the prokaryotes. Now, enzyme. So there is one enzyme which is important for the synthesis of RNA, and that is DNA dependent RNA polymerase, which is called as a RNA polymerase. In the prokaryotes, there is a presence of single RNA polymerase enzyme which synthesizes all three RNAs, that is messenger RNA, ribosomal RNA and transfer RNA. While eukaryotes contain three different types of RNA polymerase enzyme, which is designated as a RNA polymerase 1, 2 and 3. RNA polymerase 1 will synthesize ribosomal RNA. RNA polymerase 2 will synthesize messenger RNA and small nuclear RNA. RNA polymerase 3 will synthesize transfer RNA. So this is the various RNA polymerase enzyme which is present in the eukaryotic cells, which is required for the synthesis of different RNAs. And the mitochondrial RNA polymerase will synthesize all three types of RNA present in the mitochondria. This is the picture showing the structure of holoenzyme, which is an active RNA polymerase enzyme present in the prokaryotic cells. So this RNA polymerase consists of 5 subunits, which are 2 alpha, beta, beta prime and omega, which is collectively known as a core enzyme. Now, if there is a presence of 6th subunit, that is called as a sigma factor, which is attached to this core enzyme, then it is called as a holoenzyme or complete enzyme, which is a active RNA polymerase enzyme. So the active RNA polymerase or holoenzyme consists of core enzyme plus sigma factor, which give rise to the active RNA polymerase. And this RNA polymerase enzyme doesn't have any proofreading activity or exon nuclease activity. Now, stages of transcription. So transcription process is divided into 3 stages, that is initiation, elongation and termination. So first we will see the initiation. So in comparison to that of replication, for the initiation process in the transcription, we don't require any primer. And the initiation of transcription involves binding of RNA polymerase holoenzyme, which consists of core enzyme plus sigma factor, to DNA template at the promoter site. Sigma factor will facilitate binding of RNA polymerase to the promoter sequence, as well as it is important for the recognition of the promoter sequence. The promoter sequence are the characteristic sequence of DNA, which are different in the prokaryotes as well as in the eukaryotes. There are 2 promoter sequence which is available in the prokaryotic cell. First one is the Pribnobox and the second one is the -35 region nucleotide sequence. The Pribnobox is having consensuous sequence, which is TATAAT. So the consensuous sequence which is present in the Pribnobox is the TATAAT, and it is centered at minus 10 because it is found 10 base pairs away or upstream from the starting point. And the plus 1 position indicates it is the first nucleotide which is transcribed, or first nucleotide which is used for the synthesis of RNA. So this Pribnobox is centered at the minus 10, which is the 10 nucleotide away from the starting point. And the second promoter site which is present in the prokaryotic cell is the -35 region. It is called as a -35 because it is 35 nucleotide away or upstream from the start point, and it is having consensuous sequence which is TTGaka. So the consensuous sequence which is present in the -35 region nucleotide sequence is TTGaka. So this is the promoter sites available in the prokaryotic cell for the transcription, and which is identified by the sigma factor which is present in the RNA polymerase enzyme. So this is the picture showing the binding of RNA polymerase, specifically the sigma factor of the RNA polymerase enzyme, to the promoter region which is present in the prokaryotic cell. And binding of RNA polymerase enzyme to the promoter region will initiate the unwinding of DNA helix. So once RNA polymerase enzyme will bind to the promoter region, it will initiate the unwinding of the double-stranded DNA, and there will be the initiation of transcription process, which involves synthesis of short stretches of RNA molecule. So as you can see, there is an unwinding of the DNA molecule, and there is a binding of holoenzyme to the promoter sequence. Now this is the binding of core enzyme starts the synthesis of RNA. Now this sigma factor will remove from the RNA polymerase enzyme once there is a addition of N nucleotides to the RNA. Once this sigma factor will remove, it will be the transcription process will be done by core enzyme, which contains 2 alpha, 1 beta, 1 beta prime and omega. So that is about binding of core enzyme, which is important for the starting of the synthesis of RNA. And this RNA will be synthesized in 5 prime to 3 prime direction. Now elongation process. So sigma factor is released once 10 nucleotides are added, and the RNA polymerase enzyme will move along the template strand and it will continues the elongation of the transcript. And the process of the elongation of RNA chain continues until terminal signal is reached. So this is the picture showing the elongation process. This elongation is continue until the termination signal is reached. Now termination. The termination of the transcription is occur by two mechanism. First one is the row dependent termination and the second one is the row independent termination. So first we will see the row dependent termination. Row dependent termination involves the row protein associates with the RNA and it will migrates in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction. So this row protein will associates with the RNA and it will migrates in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction until it reaches the termination site. Once it reaches the termination site, the ATP dependent helicase activity of the row factor will displace the RNA polymerase enzyme from the template strand and it will result in the termination of RNA synthesis. So this is the picture showing the row dependent termination, which is having ATP dependent helicase activity. Now we will see the row independent termination. So the transcribed region of the DNA template contain the stop signals, and the simplest one is the palindromic GC read sequences. Due to this palindromic GC read sequences, there will be the formation of hairpin loop-like structure. So this hairpin loop-like structure in the RNA will disrupt many adenine and uracil base pairs in the RNA-DNA hybrid segment and may disrupt the interactions between RNA and RNA polymerase, facilitating the dissociation of the transcript. And this hairpin loop-like structure is followed by the sequence of uridine residues at the 3' end of the mRNA. So due to the palindromic sequence, there will be the formation of hairpin loop-like structure, which will help in the disruption of the RNA-DNA hybrid segment, and it will also disrupt the interaction between RNA and RNA polymerase, which will facilitate the dissociation of the transcript. So that is all about the transcription process in the prokaryotes. It is divided into three main phases, that is initiation, elongation and termination. And the enzyme responsible for the transcription process in the prokaryotes is the RNA polymerase enzyme, which contains 6 subunit, which is also called as a holo enzyme. Now we will see the multiple choice question asked from this particular topic. So the first question, which was asked in a PGI June 2008, the sequence which is present after transcription, what will be the RNA sequence? So options are, these are the all options, and the question is, after transcription, what will be the sequence present in the RNA? So we all know that in the RNA, there is no presence of thymine. So the exclude all the options which contains thymine. So the correct answer is E. Second question, which was asked in Ames November 2010, splicing activity is a function of, and the options are messenger RNA, small nuclear RNA, transfer RNA and ribosomal RNA. So we have discussed this particular question in the beginning, that is, splicing of mRNA is done by the small nuclear RNA. So the correct answer is B. Third question, which was asked in All India 2006, the sigma subunit of the prokaryotic RNA polymerase, and the options are, binds the antibiotic rifampicin, is inhibited by alpha amanitin, specifically recognizes the promoter site, and is a part of the core enzyme. So the correct answer is, sigma subunit is important for the recognition as well as for the binding to the promoter site. There are two promoter sites which is present in the prokaryotic cell. First one is the pribnobox and the second one is the minus 35 nucleotide sequence. So the correct answer is C. Another question which was asked in Kerala 2006. The DNA from which mRNA is formed by the transcription is called as a, and the options are template, anti-template, coding and transcript. So the correct answer is template strand. It is also called as a non-coding strand or sense strand. Another question is, in conversion of DNA to RNA, the enzyme required, and the question was asked in a PGI June 2008, and the options are DNA polymerase, DNA ligase, DNA polymerase 3, RNA polymerase, and the primase. So the correct answer is RNA polymerase enzyme, which is required for the synthesis of RNA from the DNA, which is a transcription process. Another question is, which was asked in All India 2004, RNA polymerase doesn't require, and the correct, and the options are template, activated precursors, divalent metal ions, and the D primer. So RNA polymerase require template, it also require activated precursors, and it also require magnesium and manganese ions, but it doesn't require primer. So the correct answer is D. Primer is required in the replication process. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it.